Hi, Kerry here. Today we're going to have a look at your balance sheet. The balance sheet, I think, is a report a lot of people don't quite understand or know how to use. Simply stated, it shows at any point in time what the business owns and what the business owes. The difference is the profit or loss that exists in the company to date, often called the equity. Any money that's being contributed by the owners as well will show up on your balance sheet. We're going to look through the sample company in QuickBooks Online again and use that as the example to understand just what makes up your balance sheet. In order to create the balance sheet, we select reports in the left-hand margin. You can see here a recommended report is the balance sheet. Choose Run. What I'd like to do is have a look at the balance sheet for last year. So I'm going to pop up here to the report period, scroll down, and choose last year. Run the report. Now we have a balance sheet that shows a snapshot of the business on December 31st. All of the items we look at now were in existence at that date. This isn't a report that shows activity. It shows things that are in most cases real. This first section, the assets, shows what you own. These are things that the business has. The first item showing is the inventory. They currently have an inventory valued at $8,010, the amount showing here on the balance sheet. These are the items they have for sale at their events. If you have a retail outlet, this number would be the value of all the items on your shelves. If you have a mail order business, these would be the items available to be sold and shipped. Basically, these are the things that you're holding, getting ready to sell them to your customers. The next item is the cash in bank. A checking account. Normally, this shows the top item. It's certainly top importance when you're managing cash flow of your business. Once again, this represents the amount of money that was in the bank on December 31st. In a future video, we'll look at linking your bank account to QuickBooks. Then you'll know that this number is always up to date. I recommend reconciling this account at the end of every month. Then you'll know you've recorded all the money you have received from sales and all of the expenses you've paid. And these are the items that will be showing up in your profit and loss, so you'll know that that report is accurate also. The accounts receivable are the amounts customers owe you for invoices you've sent out. There's an accounts receivable report you can run at any point in time in order to see who owes you these amounts and how long it's been outstanding for. Another very useful report. Next, we have the furniture and equipment. This is the equipment that's owned by the business. It's reduced by depreciation each year to represent usage and a decline in value. This is something your accountant will likely take care of for you. The value of the assets owned by this business is $53,027. The liability section shows what you owe to others. The first item to appear is taxes. In this case, it's Canadian GST and HST. If you're in British Columbia in Canada, you'll be seeing here GST and PST. And if you're in the US, there are a variety of state and county sales taxes that will be displayed here. In a later video, we'll look at recording and filing these sales tax returns. The accounts payable, wow, zero here, would be the amounts you owe to other organizations for expenses you've incurred, but not yet paid for in your business. For example, if you purchased some inventory, but you hadn't paid for it yet, this would show up here. I don't think there's any need to explain credit card debt. But at least in this case, we can see that they have enough money in the bank to pay this bill when it's due. The note payable may be something you don't come across often. It's longer-term debt that was likely raised to provide cash or purchase the initial inventory and equipment required to start the business and pay some of the expenses before payment was received for sales. The final section of the balance sheet is the equity section, the value of the organization to the owners. The owner has contributed $12,750 to the business. The profits before 2016 totaled $3,668.20. If you've seen the video about the income statement, you know that the profit for the year was in fact $11,950 as displayed here. The total of the liabilities and equity is $53,027, which agrees to total assets. This is why we call it a balance sheet, because it balances. If you review this report every month, you'll reconcile the bank and credit card accounts, count your inventory, check your accounts receivable and accounts payable, you'll know you've recorded all of the activity of the business. If that's the case, then the profit that appears on your income statement will be accurate also. Because I think this report is very important in understanding your business, I'm going to save the customization so I can easily review it whenever I want. We click Save. I'm going to call it the balance sheet last year. This report has now been saved, and next time we go to our reports, we can just click on the custom reports, and once again, here it is showing up. We certainly covered a lot today, and if there are any areas that you'd like expanded, make a note of them below, and I can do that in the next video. Also, if you would like to contact me, have any other questions directly, there's a link below to my website. You can sign up for QuickBooks Online. If you have any questions about anything or there's something else you'd like me to explore, write it in the comments section below. Then perhaps that'll be the topic of our next video. I look forward to seeing you again. Thanks. Bye.